Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amuls Academy. Today in this tutorial we are discussing about the properties in Python. So previously in this series we discussed about the decorators in detail, but in that we took all the user defined decorators. That's nothing but we defined the decorators. We defined the decorator function, we defined the decorator class, then we applied that decorator function or class on the another function or method, right? But there are some built-in decorators also. So in that we are learning three basic important built-in decorators. So the first one is called property decorator. The second one is class method decorator. And third one is static method decorator. So we are learning these three built-in decorators. So today in this tutorial we'll talk about the property decorators. In the next tutorial we'll talk about the class method decorator and static method decorator. Okay, so here in this property decorator I'm dividing it to part 1 and part 2, because otherwise it will become very lengthy. I need to explain how we can use property decorator, as well as I need to explain how we can use this property as function also. That's why I'll divide this as part 1 and part 2. So today we'll do part 1. In the next tutorial we'll do part 2. And next to next tutorial we'll discuss about these decorators. Okay. Okay, so this property decorator is a built-in decorator. So we know that why we use decorator, because using decorator we can change the class method or attribute without affecting the client side code. In the same way, this property decorator also has some purpose. So the first one is it will allow us to use class method as attribute. Okay, so in this tutorial I will show you the example for this and we'll see how this property will do this. And the second purpose is we can replace setter method and getter method by using this property decorator. This we'll discuss in the next tutorial along with the property function. Okay, so now we'll see how we can use class method as attributes in Python. So first of all, in Python file I'll take a class, because we'll use this property decorator on the class. So I'll take a class named student. So next I'll take initialization method to self. I'll take two attributes. First one is name and second one is grade. Okay, so here self dot name is equal to name, self dot grade equal to grade, and here I'll take another attribute as self dot message. It will print a message. So this will print a message, okay, self.name got grade, self grade. Okay, so it will print like this. If I give name as Amulya, so Amulya got grade. If I give grade as B, Amulya got grade B. It will print like that. Okay, so next, this is my class. Okay, it contains only one method, that is the initialization method. Now I can create an object. So I'll take like this. You can take any object name, right? Now I need to pass the name and grade, because here we can see in the initialization method you can see name and grade. So I'll pass name as Nia and grade as B. Okay, so now if I want to print name, grade or message, then I can write like this, print, okay, student1 dot name So grade message. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, we can get Nia B. Nia got grade B. So if I want to print any message here like name, here we can see name Nia grade B, Nia got grade B. This is fine. So now I want to change the grade. So I can change like this. Okay, I can mention student 1 dot grade and I can mention some other grade like A. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, it will print name as Nia, grade as A. Okay, it is changed, but here we can see the message, it contains Nia got grade B. Okay, that's because if you change the value of an attribute of a class, other attributes which are derived from that class won't automatically update. Okay, so that's why here we can see the grade got updated, but the attribute message which is contains the self.grade is not updated. Okay, it won't automatically update it. That's why we can see grade B here. So now if any client or any other person is using your class, then they'll get the wrong output, right? Here we can see we are getting wrong grade here, right? So we need to fix it. So for that, what we can do is, instead of attribute, we can take this in a method. Okay, then we'll get the proper output. That is like this. Instead of this, here we can see the attribute name as message. So here what I'll do is, I'll define a method called message. So here I'll take self. Okay, so next this will return this. So instead of message attribute, I took message method now. Okay, so now if I execute it as a method, okay, here we'll get the proper output, Nia A, Nia got grade A. So here we are getting everything perfect, right? But here we can see we did a change here in the class. Okay, in the class student, we converted the attribute to method. Because of that change, our client or the person who is using this class need to change this message. Previously it was an attribute, so we didn't use this parenthesis, we mentioned like this, but after converting it to method, to call that method we need to use the parenthesis. Now imagine that many clients or persons are using this class in their project or program, and their project or program contains thousands of lines. Then wherever they use this message attribute, now they need to convert it to method. Okay, that's not the easy task, and clients won't be happy with that. It is the extra work, right? The people who used our previous class where the message was attribute, now they need to convert that to method. If they didn't change that, then we'll get the output like this. Okay, we'll get the object. Okay, we won't get the proper output. So now we need to make the change to the class, otherwise we won't get the proper output. But we don't want to make our client unhappy. We don't want to burden them with the changes, right? That time what we need to do, in this case we can use the property decorator, which will allow us to change the class without affecting the client code. So that's nothing but, here if I use the property decorator here, like above this message, we'll use property decorator like this, at and property. If you remember while explaining about the decorator, I said using decorator is very easy. We need to mention the at symbol followed by the decorator function name or class name. But writing decorator is tough. Because here we are using the built-in decorator, we just need to mention the name. Okay, so I'll just mention property. And here we can see I'm using it as an attribute. Okay, I'm not calling this method now. So now if I save this and run this, here we can see it will give the output. Okay, we are getting the output. This property decorator allow us to use a method as attribute. Okay, this is the one purpose of the property decorator. So now one of the other client came to me and he want to assign here message. He want to change the message. For example, I'll remove this. He want to set the message. Like he'll give message. Like I'll take Amulya, my name, got grade A. He'll set this message. Now he want to get name and grade as Amulya and A. Okay, so now if I save this, what will happen? We'll get the attribute error. Here we can see can't set attribute. We can't set attribute like this. Now our client came to us. He want to do these changes and he is asking us to do changes in our class. So we want to value our client's demand. So we need to change in our class. Okay. So here we want to set the attribute. So for that we need to use setter method. Okay. So the setter method is nothing but which will allow us to set the attribute values. So here what I'll do is I'll remove this property decorator. Okay. Because first I will show you if I didn't use any decorator, then how this setter method will affect the client. Okay. So here I'm not using any decorator. Okay. So I can give any name to setter here. So I'll give method name as setter, self and message. Because I want to set the message, so here I'll take message. Okay. So now what I'll do is I'll take a variable. You can take any variable. I'll take sent. So next I'll split the message now. So why? Because here we can see client will give this message. Now to get the name and grade from this, I need to split this message, right? So that's why I'm doing this message.split space. Wherever you will get space, split the message. So it will contain Amulya got grade A. So this split will return a list. So sent will be a list. It contains Amulya in the 0th index, got in the 1st index, grade in the 2nd index, A in the 3rd index. Okay. So if you want, I'll print and I'll show you. So I'll just print sent. Okay. So you can see the output later. Now I need to get the name and grade. So here I'll write self.name. Okay. As sent the list name and 0th index. Because name will be in the beginning of the message and that will be stored in the 0th index. That's why I'll take name as sent of 0. Okay. So now next I want grade. So I'll take sent minus 1. Because grade will be present in the last and it will be stored in the last index. We know that the last index is always minus 1. If I take the negative indexing, then the last value index will be minus 1. Okay. But here to call this method, what we need to use? We can't write like this, right? We need to write like student1.setter. Then we need to use this message inside that. Then it will work. We can't write like this. So I'll commit this. Okay, so now if I save this and run this. Okay, so sorry, because I didn't use parenthesis and I didn't use the property decorator also. That's why here I'm getting the object. But here we can see the list, as I said, the sent list, Amulya got grade A. So now name will be assigned to Amulya, grade is A. Here we can see. Okay, so we can set the attribute value like this. But our client wanted like this, right? Now he didn't want to mention like this. He wanted like this, student1.message as Amulya got grade A. He want to mention like this. Okay. He didn't want to call this setter method. Now what to do? So in these cases, we can use the property decorator, which will help us. Okay. So here, client no need to change anything. He can set the attribute like this. But for this, here we'll mention the property, right? Next here, what we need to do is, so this will be the setter method. So if client want to mention like this, then I need to change the name of this. Okay, I need to mention it as message, because here we can see, so the method name where we applied the property decorator is message. So I need to mention this method name also message, and here I can mention, so at message dot setter. Okay, message dot setter decorator. Okay, so now if I run this, here you can see in the client side, we set the attribute like this. We didn't call the setter method. We just mentioned object name dot message as Amulya got grade A. Now if I save this and run this, here we can see we are getting the output. Amulya got grade A. It got updated and we can see the message. We didn't get the attribute error. So this is about the property decorator, which allows us to use a method as the attribute. In the next tutorial also, we'll continue the discussion on this decorator. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.